Hi there. In this video, I'm going to show you the easiest way to add someone else, like an employee or maybe an agency you're working with, to have access to manage your Instagram account. And if you're an agency, I'm also going to show you the best way to request access and make it super simple for your clients to grant that access to you. Let's do it. There are three requirements for you to be able to add someone else to manage your Instagram account. The first one is you need to have an Instagram business account, and I'm going to show you how you can get that easily. The second one is you need to have a Facebook page. This may sound surprising, but don't worry about it. You don't have to put any content on it or maintain the page. It just needs to exist. And the third thing is you also need a Meta Business Manager account. Before we continue, I'll give you a quick explanation why we need to set up these three things. Essentially, granting access to someone else is only possible through Meta Business Manager, and it's done through your Facebook page. This may sound complicated, but trust me, it is the easiest way for you to manage access and to maintain control as well when you give access to partners like agencies and even your employees. There's no way to share access to your Instagram directly from the Instagram app without doing these things. What you're able to do, of course, is share your Instagram username and password, but I do not recommend that. One of the reasons is security. You don't know where your username and password will really go and where it's stored, but also there is going to be a lot of hassle because of two-factor authentication when the other person wants to log into your account. So please do not use this method. So let's check how we can set these things up. Step number one, let's switch your Instagram account to a business account. There is no real downside to this. The only thing is that your account will be automatically public. So there's no way to have a private account under this setting. So if you currently do not have your Instagram account set as a business account, then let's change that setting. Click on the hamburger menu on the right upper hand side. Then click on settings and privacy, and then scroll to account type and tools. And once you're there, you should have the setting available to click on switch to professional account. It will show you some benefits of why you should switch to a professional account and go through that and continue to make that change. That's step number one done. Step number two, let's create your Meta Business Manager account. What you should do is go to business.facebook.com/create and you will see this website. Then you must log in with a Facebook account. This is actually another requirement. You do need a Facebook account. Just using your Instagram is not enough because you will only be able to access Meta Business Suite, which is a simplified version of Business Manager, and it doesn't actually give us all of the control that we need in order to grant access to, for example, a partner. Once you're logged in, you should be able to see this screen and have the ability to create an account. So click create an account, and then fill in the business and account name. So for example, let's call it Leadsie, which is the name of our business. And you set up your name as well as your email address. So for example, in my case, it's Johannes and johannes@leadsie.com. So now you can see that in my case, it says I already have an account. You should obviously not see this message and you will be able to continue from here. Finish the steps, and once you're done, then we have step number two completed. Step number three, let's create your page. Before we do that, we do a quick check. So you should see a similar page as you can see here on my screen with your business settings, it should say here, which is your new business manager that you just created. And you should see your name here as one of the people in this business manager. One more thing I would recommend is if you go to your business info, you can also specify some more information about the business. I also recommend you to force everyone in your business manager to have two-factor authentication switched on. This will make it much more secure. So if any of your employees or admins accounts are compromised, then it will be much harder for any hackers to get into your accounts. Lastly, the next step that we want to do is we want to create your page. So go to your pages. You won't be able to see any page here, most likely. So what we do is we click add and we click on create new page. Then select whatever category is most suitable for you and give it a name and choose a category. I already have created the page, so I'm not going to click this, but once you've clicked it, you will be able to see the page here in your business manager. Now our last step is to connect our Instagram account to the Facebook page. So in order to do that, we have two options. We can either do it from our Instagram app or we can do it from Facebook on your desktop. Let me show you first how to do it from your desktop. Go to facebook.com and then make sure you change your account to switch into the page. So for example, here I'm in the Leadsie test business page. The next step is to go to settings and privacy. So let's click on that. And then we go to settings. And here we can click on linked accounts. And it gives you the options of Instagram and WhatsApp, but the standard should be Instagram. So here we click on connect account. You can see that it confirms what this will do. And it's only possible with a professional Instagram account. But luckily we've already set that up. So we click continue. I would give these permissions here. And then what we need to do now is to sign in with our Instagram account. And that's it. Now Instagram and this Facebook page are connected and we can proceed with actually sharing the permissions to the Instagram account. For completeness, let me quickly show you how you can connect your Facebook page to your Instagram account from your Instagram app. So go to your Instagram profile and then click on edit profile. Then you should be able to see a section that's called public business information. And you can see it says page there and that you can connect or create a page. Click on that. And then you are able to say connect a page, click continue and log into your Facebook. From there, you should be able to make this connection and we're all good. Now let's talk about how we can assign permissions to manage your Instagram account from your Meta Business Manager, which is the new place for you to manage all these permissions very easily. Okay, so what you now will be able to see is your Facebook page because we've added it to the Business Manager. You should also see your Instagram account here in your Business Manager under Instagram accounts. If you don't, then it's not actually a problem, but you can add your Instagram account here by clicking connect your Instagram account and adding it here. However, because your Instagram account is connected to the page, all of the permissions are actually managed through your page permissions. So this is something that many businesses and agencies don't properly know, but you don't actually need to connect your Instagram separately here in this Instagram accounts overview. And you also don't necessarily need to assign partners. There's one exception, which has to do with Instagram commerce. So if you are someone who is selling products through Instagram directly, then you need to have it in there and you need to be able to assign your partners in there. But we'll talk about this separately. So how do we assign access to, let's say, an employee to this Instagram account? So what you need to do is, if it's an employee and not a partner or like an agency, you go to users and you click on people and then you click on invite people and you put in their email address, johannes2@leadsie.com, and you click next. And then you specify which permissions should this person have. Now, if you want this person to be able to essentially just manage the Instagram account, you don't need to select all of these things. You just leave it at basic and we continue to next. We select the page and here we select, I would recommend to give them all of the permissions for this page, but you can also choose to not give some permissions for the page. Now, again, remember by assigning permissions to the page, this user will also be able to manage your content for Instagram and also see and create reels, all the things that you can see here. If you have the Instagram here as well, you could assign that too. But as I said, it actually does not make a difference, except when you have an Instagram commerce account. So we click invite. I'm not going to do this now because this is just not a real email address. But once you've done that, your employee will have an invitation and it will be shown in your dashboard like this person here where it says invited. Now let's talk about how you can give access to a partner. So for example, an agency that you're working with. The more complicated way is to do this via Meta Business Manager. And I'm going to mention at this stage already that we at Leadsie have built a tool to make this process much, much simpler. And I will show you that in a second. So if you're an agency and you're requesting access to Facebook assets frequently, you may want to check this out. But yeah, so if you are a brand and you want to give access to your Instagram account to a partner, what you can do is you go to your business manager, you need to go to partners and then click on add and then click on give a partner access to your assets. And you need to put in your partner's business ID. So you need to know the business ID that they have. So in my case, I'm going to use this one. Click next. And then again, if you just want to give access to your Instagram and your page with that, select the page, select everything, choose if you want to give revenue as well. And again, if you want, you can also select Instagram here. But again, it is not needed unless you're doing Instagram commerce because the page is connected to Instagram. So let's click save changes and then your partner will have received a confirmation that they have received this access. Now, this is all relatively simple if you know your partner's business manager ID and if you're also familiar with using business manager correctly. If you are an agency, you know that this is not always the case. So that's why we've built Leadsie. With Leadsie, sharing is much, much easier. So you basically send a link to your clients to give you access to certain things. For example, in this case, I'm requesting access to a page at Instagram. Your client just needs to connect with Facebook, give some permissions, and then they're able to choose which page to give you access to and which Instagram account. They click confirm access and it's done. This process is obviously much simpler and saves you a lot of hassle when you want to get access to Instagram accounts and Facebook accounts, but also we support Google, all the different Google platforms and even TikTok and a lot more integration soon. So check us out if you are requesting access frequently from your clients. So now you're probably wondering, so I've given this access, but how does someone now manage my Instagram, right? That's a great question. The way this works is through your Meta Business Suite. I've mentioned this in the beginning. This is a simplified but slightly different version to Meta Business Manager. How do we get there? One way to get there, and I'm sure there are many others, is to type in the following. business.facebook.com/latest. So when you go there, you will be able to, on the left-hand side, select your business manager and then basically the profile. So your Facebook page with the Instagram. So let's look at this example here. So we have this business manager called Growth Consultant. So this could be your business manager, or if you're an agency, it's your agency's business manager. And here you have different profiles, right? So you have this one, which only has a Facebook page, another one with just a Facebook page. And then we have Leadsie and the Leadsie test page with Facebook and Instagram. So it says Facebook and Instagram because both accounts are connected. So that is what I mentioned in the beginning. Once your Facebook page is connected to Instagram and Facebook is shared, automatically you also get the permissions to do things with Instagram. So let's click on that. And what we can see here is, again, both of these are connected. We can create posts here and we can actually create posts for both Instagram and for Facebook. So that should be fine. You can also see a preview of both of them. You can also create reels, you can create stories, and you can also manage your previous content here, stories, and so on. You can also respond to comments on both Instagram and Facebook, and also to messages, including some spam messages, which these are not real messages, don't worry about it. But yeah, so basically all of your profiles can be managed from your business suite account. And one more thing to add, If you're using a third-party tool, like for example, Hootsuite, then by assigning the access as I showed you, the different people that have received this access can also use third-party tools in order to post content on Facebook or on Instagram through that as well. And obviously our tool, Leadsie, also gives you this permission to use a third-party tool or to use Business Suite directly. So I hope this answers all your questions around how to give an employee or another business like an agency access to your Instagram account. And if you have any questions, just put a comment down below. My last words go out to agencies who are frequently onboarding clients and need access. Try out Leadsie. It makes getting access to all of these different assets much simpler for your clients. And we have a 14-day free trial, so you can try out Leadsie without putting in a credit card and see how we're making onboarding hassle-free. To date, we have given access to 140,000 different accounts and assets, and over 2,000 agencies have used us. So please check us out. And again, if you have any questions, feel free to reach out. Thank you so much.